Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean the Fog Crawler. Today we're going to show you how to make mozzarella cheese in cast iron.
Hi, I'm Joni. Today's episode we're featured at the family homestead up here at East House. We hope you enjoy it.
There's only four ingredients in this cheese. Milk, citric acid, liquid rennet, and cheese salt. Alright, the first thing we do is take our gallon of milk and we pour it right in the Dutch oven. We're checking the temperature of the milk, and when it gets to 55 degrees, we're going to add the citric acid. So in goes the citric acid. We're going to stir this up a bit. The citric acid is going to acidify the milk and it's going to help start the curdling process. And this is a 5-quart oven. It's a 10-inch deep. I could have used a 12 regular, but the recipe calls for at least a 5-quart pot. And I've just got one loose ring of coals underneath the Dutch oven. I didn't want to heat the milk up too fast. Once you get up to about 80 degrees, you'll see clear signs of the curdling process starting. Okay, we're at 90 degrees, so we're gonna take it off the heat. Rennet. And the rennet is going to coagulate the proteins, turn them into solids, separate them from the liquid whey. We're going to stir this for 30 seconds, then we're going to put the lid back on and leave it undisturbed for about 10 minutes. It's been 10 minutes, let's see what it looks like. We should notice a considerable difference. Oh yeah. See how it's almost set up solid? So what we do now is we cut the curds up.
You want to start out cutting them in parallel lines one way.
Notice you can also, you can see the liquid whey now. It's got a yellowish color to it.
Then parallel cut the opposite way through.
Okay, now we're going to heat this up to about 105, stir it. While we're doing that, that's going to separate the curd from the whey a little bit more. Okay, we've reached 105 degrees. So what our next step will be is to separate this curd from the liquid whey. I'm just gently pressing the curd up against the side of the oven just to try to help extract some more whey. And when we're done and we get all this curd out, it should yield about a pound of mozzarella cheese. Okay, we're taking the curd. We're just going to place the curd in this strainer over here.
So he has a slotted spoon ladle and the spatula pressing out the liquid.
I've taken the curd and separated it from the whey. Now I'm going to heat the whey up to 175 degrees. Okay, I'm going to pour the salt into the whey now. I'm basically sacrificing this whey. I'm going to be using it as a salt bath. It's going to salt my cheese when we melt the curds. There's actually another way you could add the salt to the cheese, and that's sprinkling it directly onto it when you're stretching it. I like this way better because it gives a milder saltiness to the cheese.
Way better.
Okay, our bath is up to 175, so now we're going to put the cheese, put the curd, still technically a curd. So what we're going to do now is we're going to melt this curd. That's going to be when it turns to mozzarella cheese. When the internal temperature of this curd reaches 135, we can start stretching our cheese. I believe the cheese might be ready to stretch. We're going to give it a test right now and find out. First thing I want to do is compact it a little bit. Now I think we need to heat it up a little bit more. See how when I try to stretch it? Watch, it'll break. Almost there. Okay, now we're getting that good stretch. So now we're going to take, we're going to form it into a ball. Okay, I'm going to take our mozzarella ball, put the finishing touches on it here, and we're going to put it in this ice water bath for about a half hour. I'm towel drying the cheese off from the ice water bath. Now we're going to slice it up.
Yeah, cheese head.
So what would you do with this, Joan?
I would probably slice it up and put it on some fresh tomatoes and sprinkle a little bit of balsamic vinaigrette on it. What would you do with it, Fog Crawler?
Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do with it. I'm going to do some pretty thick slices here. And I'm going to cut these into sticks. And I'm going to make deep-fried mozzarella sticks.
Of course
you are. Fog crawler style. I trimmed up the ends. Now I'm just going to take the cheese stick, roll it around in some egg, put it in the breadcrumbs, coat it real nice. Then we'll heat up some oil and deep fry these for just like about 30 seconds. Here's my homemade mozzarella cheese sticks ready to be deep fried in olive oil.
Yeah, they brown fast. They look absolutely wonderful.
From a gallon of milk to a homemade mozzarella stick. Yeah, baby. Here, hug you. Woohoo! Watch out, it's hot. Fog crawler and little hog approved. I hope you enjoyed today's webisode. This is Dean, the fog crawler. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
Thanks for watching. I'm Joni, and until the next time, happy trails to you. Until the next time.